Sunday afternoon in the city of Three Rivers, home for the Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC Sports, presented by Ed Shave Gel. 60th straight sellout at Mellon Arena, 17,000 plus here to watch Game 2, the Pittsburgh Penguins and the New York Rangers. By Roosevelt and Malkin. Five-man scrum, it squirts on back. Ryan Whitney with it there. Got it on to Malkin. Tries to get loose. Malkin centered one in front. Scores! Goal!
Well, it's just a matter of time for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Good chances earlier. If Evgeny Malkin makes a quick little move and just gets the puck to the front of the net. But the ability of Jordan Staal to take the puck from his backhand to his forehand and elevate the puck over Henrik Lundqvist, who was down early. So the patience in front of the net. And a 1-0 lead for the Penguins.
And the rotation was there for the Rangers. They had numbers back. Gomez rotated right. Roosevelt rotated right. Staal was in good position. Mark Staal. But you're right. The skill level of Jordan to elevate that puck makes a difference.
Flip the bouncer in front. Knifed away to the corner by Scuderi. And flip back down the ice. Is it going to go in? Yes!
Well, one near opportunity for the Rangers. The chance for Drury to Yager, a missed redirect, and off the boards in the glass. I believe it was Adam Hall who chipped the puck up off the glass. It takes a great bounce and rolls right into the empty net of the New York Rangers, and a 2-0 lead.
In front, scramble for it there, and Drury couldn't get to it. And it is a shutout for Marc-Andre Fleury, and more is happening as Gill moves in on Avery, and everybody rushes in.
Well, this all started when the puck got in behind Marc-Andre Fleury. Sean Avery gave a couple shots to Marc-Andre Fleury in the back of the legs. And as time was coming off the clock, right when the clock hit zero, Marc-Andre Fleury took a stick, just like he did in the series before against the Ottawa Senators and Marty Lapointe. He hit it between the legs, and that's what set Avery off. Avery initiated. But there's a quick little shot by Fleury. But this was after Avery gave him a couple shots with the stick in the back of the leg. And then Gill and LaRock and Malone and everybody comes to the fray to the right of Marc-Andre Fleury.
Officials very wary of a powder keg here because the teams have to cross one another to exit. Rangers are pretty much gone. Girardi standing around perhaps to get word with one of the officials, but the Penguins have a 2-0 win and a 2-0 lead in the series. Winning goal in the game came some time ago. The extra was from Adam Hall into the empty net.
No, it was good. Well, it was more like a playoff hockey type of game. And you got to fight for every inch on the ice. And I thought both teams played well. But I like our chances. We generate a lot of chances. Lundqvist was outstanding to keep his team into the game. But I like the way that we were aggressive tonight.
Three power plays in the first period, and you seem to shut him down on the power play the whole evening, especially down at the end too.
Yeah, Yeah, especially the last two times they were on a power play. Guys did a fantastic job, man. Special team is always a key factor. We finished today plus one, and obviously when you finish plus with a special team, you put yourself in a good position to win.
It comes down to power play and penalty most of the time in the playoffs, and especially against New York, which is, after all, great goaltender. They're playing real defensive system. There's not 5-on-5. There's not much going on there. You can't make mistakes. If you make mistakes with the puck, they're going another way. The outnumber rush, and that's a key. We recognize that, and we just make sure the puck gets out every time in our zone, or when it gets deep the other way. So it's just a little thing, but that makes a big difference.
You'd be faced with the challenge of killing off a couple of power plays that late in the game,
I think the penalty was great. It was great, and when they had chances, and Flower stopped those. So what can you say? Defensive offer was really good.
You guys had a ton of chances today. I mean, and Jordan Staal finally cashed in there to make it 1-0. Just talk a little bit about how well their goalie played today.
It was great. Stopped a lot of chances. We could have put on 3-4 before that goal we got, and that's being expected. He's really good during the regular season, and that's one of the biggest reasons they made the playoffs. And we have to know that. And nobody's a goalie that you can't put the puck behind him. You just keep shooting. At some point, it'll go in.
What were you thinking when they waved off that goal?
I think it's very obvious. The puck was underneath Flower's bat, and you can't push the puck in when the goalie has it.
Now you guys keep home ice advantage going up to New York. You just talk a little bit about it. You guys struggled a little bit up there in the regular season, but it's the playoffs now. Just going up to New York and trying to hold on to this home ice advantage.
What happened in the regular season, it doesn't really matter. And it's a long year, and situations happen. You're in the road, and you might be tired. It's nothing. It's a new season now, and we're starting 0-0 again in the first game, and it's just, we just have to be smart. The situation is a little different, the mentality in the playoffs, because you're playing against the same team the whole time, so there's no secret.
Today a little different than game one, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, we expected that. We had to play a little different than the first game. Obviously, you had to open up in the first a little more and try to use our firepower, and it worked, and now we just played smart defensively. They don't give you much 5-on-5, and we knew that, and we'd have to do the same thing and use our power plays as an advantage.
It got better and better since mid-season. We made some trades. We want to get two guys that can kill penalties. Three guys, actually. Us, Dupes, and Kiel are doing a great job helping us out. But I think the goalie's always the best killer out there. Fleury's playing great. But we've been improving a lot since maybe mid-season. And, we know how important it is right now. And we get the job done.
Just talk about that last one, about the last kill.
That was huge. This is key in the game, you want to kill it. You want to kill them all. That's what we did tonight. Rangers have a great power play. We're going to have to bring that to the road right now, because we got game three coming up, and we definitely want to kill them in that game too.
Sign of a good team taking advantage of a situation. On the replay, it looked like the puck wasn't frozen, should have counted as a goal, but you guys turned right around and turned it into an advantage for yourselves.
Well, definitely. It's going to happen, their goal in game one, the high stick on Drury, same thing. You get good call, you get bad calls. It's going to happen. We got a good one out there. I think that might be a turning point of the game.
People say, a series really doesn't start until you play that first game on the road. You hold serve here, keep home ice. How important is it to set the tone in New York coming up later this week?
Oh, it's huge. We're going to have to focus on game three now. Yes, we played well at home. Now it's going to be wired out there. We know we haven't been that successful down there this year, but that was regular season. We have to try to get that behind us and just try to go with them and do the same thing that we did at home.
Thanks, Max.
In frenzy inside and outside of Melt Arena for this game against a heated rival in the New York Rangers. Amy Marcinkiewicz continues our live Team 11 coverage with that story. Amy?
Well, I don't know if it gets any better than this. Great weather outside, a big screen TV and a front row seat. That's right. Just a little bit ago, this whole place was full of fans, and they were having a great time up close and personal, and they loved it out here. They were cheering. They just loved watching this game, and of course, with a big win, they were very excited. And of course, everybody said to me, it was free. They got to watch the game for free and had all this excitement. I talked to some of them at the height of the game.
I think we definitely have a chance to clinch it all, especially going into New York next week.
Very confident. We're playing really well. I'm just so excited. I mean, it's just great with the young group of talent the Pens have. And then the group of the base of fans we have. It's just awesome.